is Doris from the Art and Nature Center at the Peabody Essex Museum, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create your own leaf ornaments, or at least to preserve leaves for the future. So I have picked a few leaves from outside that had fallen on the ground earlier, and I've stuck them in this really thick cookbook so that they can dry and flatten out. So they've been in here for a couple days, they're nice and dry, and they're beautifully flat. So I'm gonna take my leaves out. If your leaves are still wet and are still kind of crinkly, it's gonna be tricky to do this project, so. And I also took the stems off because the stems get in the way. Here is my leaf collection. And the other things you'll need for this project are some hand towels. Any towels really work, but these are nice because they're smooth. They don't have terry cloth, so they're easier to press flat. An iron and some wax paper. So make sure you have an adult's permission to use the iron and an adult's supervision while you're using the iron. It's on its lowest setting, so it's not super hot, but irons are always a lot hotter than anything we would want to touch, so you're never gonna touch the hot surface over here. And the way this project works is we're sealing our leaves inside of the wax paper. And in order to do that, we need to iron the paper. So I'm gonna put a towel down to protect my table. If you have an ironing board, you can do this on top of the ironing board. Then I want to put some wax paper down that I'm going to put the leaves on top of. And then I'm going to lay my leaves out. And I want to make sure there's enough space between them that I can cut them out after I iron them. I wanted to arrange the little ones together so they can be cut out together. So I want to make sure I'm using the majority of the wax paper here, but also that there's enough space between them so if they slide when I'm ironing, they don't slide into one another. So I have them all laid out on my wax paper, and I'm going to get another sheet of wax paper to cover over the top of them. And I'm gonna lay it on top just like that. I wanna move this one over because it's already slid. Now, I'm going to very carefully, gently put my other towel on top. There we go. So my iron has been plugged in and is preheating to its lowest setting. The reason I have this towel on top is so my iron doesn't touch the wax paper and get sticky. So I've got my iron on the lowest setting. It doesn't need any water in it. It doesn't need to steam. And you always want your iron to be moving. You want it to be moving so you don't accidentally burn a spot. And I like to hold the cord out of the way as well. So I am pressing and moving my iron in circular motions, slowly and gently, so I don't accidentally push the leaves together underneath here. And what you are trying to do is to melt that wax paper together. So I can see it's starting to work. There's some areas that I see aren't stuck. You'll see like little bubbles kind of, and the outside of the leaves you'll be able to tell is not quite as sealed. So the more you do it, you'll be able to see it sealing. And every once in a while, you'll just peek at your work. I'm gonna do a little bit more over in this corner, but it looks really good around most of these. So I am definitely getting my leaves sealed in between the wax paper. All right, I'm gonna set my iron aside. Always want to be really careful with where you set your iron and that it's set on its base so the hot part isn't touching anything. So now, as soon as I pick this up, you'll be able to really tell. So those are sealed in there. It's no longer two pieces, it's one piece. The next step will be to cut them out. All right, I've got my scissors and my hole punch, and I've got some string too. And we're gonna make them into ornaments. Okay, so now I'm going to cut out my leaves. I don't want to cut too close to them. I want to give them some space around them so the wax paper stays sealed. You'll see there's a bit of a halo around each leaf where it hasn't sealed because the leaf is in the way. So you want to cut like half an inch away from that halo. And they work just like this as sort of a table decoration, or you can use your hole punch and punch a hole in one side, and then you can hang them from the ceiling, So they look like falling leaves. Just put my string through that hole. And then I'm gonna hold the two ends together like this and tie them in a knot. Just a very simple knot. And now I have a hanging leaf decoration. All right, I've got all my finished leaf ornaments here. And they hang at different heights. You could make that even more extreme by making really long loops. And I think they look really great. They'll be super fun hanging from the ceiling. They'll twirl in the breeze a little bit. And it's fun because they're all different colors. You can collect whatever color leaves you really like best. You can try and get as many different colors as you want. You can even collect green ones and press them. And they'll stay green once they're dry. You could draw on them before you iron them in. And then they'll have little faces or little decorations, whatever you'd like to do. I think this is a super fun project because now they're gonna last forever. Thank you so much for watching. Can't wait to see what you create. Use the hashtag PemPod and the hashtag PeebodyEssex to share with us. And happy fall!